of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Yale Bulldogs and the Purdue Boilermakers.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of the other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Boilermakers should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them, though?
Hey, here's my keys for them tonight. Number one, get the ball on the interior. See if you can get that big man into foul trouble. Second, make sure every possession you have is a good possession. Don't turn the rock over. Thirdly, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Try to go inside.
Picks off the pass. The point guard gets the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. They look to get it to the inside. The Bulldogs have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad. I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. He takes a three.
Shot didn't fall in, but it was a great use of the screen.
Trying to feed inside. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
On the outside.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Contact causes the shot to come off. Dumps it in.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with his back. Where's he going?
The point guard gets the ball. Top of the circle. Questionable shot selection there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Time to pick up the defense here now. Are they confused about who goes where on that double team?
Oh, there's no doubt.
On the dribble, gives it up.
There's the trap.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love him.
The people here really appreciate what he brings to the table.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Well, the arc looked good. There's a reason they're called free throws. Let's see if they go 2-for-1 here, Dick. Bailey is eager and excited to compete.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Tries a three. Tickles a twine. Steals a pass. Shot clock is dead. They'll work it around the arc. Gave it up. The power forward takes the pass. Gets up to make the block. Looking for a good shot. For two. And off the mark. Throws it up, hoping for the best. The ball goes out of bounds. The half. The Bulldogs lead by three. All right, let's check in. Third member of our team again. Here's Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Fake. He goes with a baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Goes up for two. The layup.
Think right now that a focus defensively.
This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup.
Watch out, the 5-second count is getting close, Brad.
Doesn't go. Comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
He's in a three-quarter position trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball. High post screen, going to use it.
Top of the circle. He doesn't get the hook. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. On the dribble, gives it up. Here's the three ball. He nails the shot. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes in. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Gave it up. Kicks it out. Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call, though, by the official.
And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Misses the second shot. The point guard with the ball. The Bulldogs have quite a few seniors in their lineup, which definitely is to their benefit.
It is, Brad. Seniors may be the only reason why coaches sleep at night. They rarely make bad decisions, and you can trust them on the court.
He tries to knock down the three.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
The power forward with the ball. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He goes to the line, shooting two. He hits it. He hits the second shot. For two.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Good Barishnikov right there. You always were a dancer. Look at that spacing.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
They work the perimeter. Defenders right up on him. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Off the rim and no good. On the outside. Got a nice screen. He makes the block. And now in transition, going the other way. Great shot. No timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Well, we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
The center gets the ball. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. He missed the inside shot off the screen.
And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock, possession, or their timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Hits the second shot. Feed. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. He used the sky hook, the jump hook, and now a spin move to the goal.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few in your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, and an inside presence will separate your team from others.
And yet another foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleader as the mascot, everybody involved.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Second one is good.
Gotta get one on this possession, baby.
Yeah.
much-needed breather with that timeout. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
He takes the shot. Rims out. Pulls it down.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it, keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Purdue opened the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.